In this video, I'm going to show you how to assess regional and segmental intervertebral motion of the upper thoracic spine in extension.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Passive assessment of the quantity and quality of segmental intervertebral motion, also known as motion palpation, is part of the diagnostic clinical expertise of many old practitioners to guide decisions on a therapeutic strategy for patients with spinal pain. Hypermobility indicates mobilizing interventions, while hypermobility calls for a stabilizing approach. A study done by Walker et al. In the year 2015 evaluated the reliability of passive segmental assessment of the thoracic spine on restricted and painful segments and found only poor to low-level agreement between the raters. For this reason, the clinical value of passive thoracic spine assessment is weak. In order to perform regional range of motion assessment for upper thoracic extension of vertebrae T1 till T4, have your patient sit upright at the edge of the bench while the examiner stands on the side to be examined. The bench height should be adjusted so that your patient's shoulder is at the same height as your own. Then ask your patient to put his hands behind his cervical spine and his elbows together and establish contact with the patient's upper arm on the contralateral side by placing your arm below your patient's elbow. Fixate your patient's vertebrae T5 with your thenar eminence into ventrocranial direction. Bring your patient slightly forward at the hip and perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of extension, ipsilateral lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation. This movement causes maximal compression of the facet joints of the upper thoracic spine on the ipsilateral side. The whole movement is judged on resistance during motion and at end range of motion, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the other side. In order to continue with segmental assessment of, say, T2 and T3, have your patient sit straight again. Fixate the spinous process of T3 with your thenar eminence into ventrocranial direction and bring your patient slightly forward at the hip. Then perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of extension, ipsilateral, lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation again. To test each component of intervertebral motion, slightly move out of the end range and now test extension between T2 and T3 by pushing the spinous process of T3 ventrocranially. To assess rotation, move on to the ipsilateral transverse process of T3. Be aware that the transverse process is about 1 to 2 centimeters higher than the spinous process of the same level in the thoracic spine, and then move it ventrally with your thenar eminence or thumb. For the lateral flexion component, place your thumb ipsilaterally between the spinous processes of T2 and T3 and move your patient's thoracic spine into lateral flexion with your upper arm. Each component is judged on resistance during motion and feel, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the segment above or below. All right, this was our video on intervertebral motion assessment of upper thoracic extension. If you want to learn how to assess intervertebral motion of the mid and lower thoracic spine in extension, click on the video right next to me. As always, thank you very much for watching. Feel free to give this video a like and share it if you liked it. If you want to see more of us, check us out on other social media channels. For all of our videos, including articles, statistical values, and more, have a look at our very own assessment ebook and app. Links can be found in the description down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.